I'm going to show you guys how you can find low content or no content Amazon KDP niches using Google for free. This comes from a comment on my YouTube. Austin Designer said, thank you so much. Is there a method to just know the results of KDP paperback, notebook, puzzle book, coloring book? So I'm going to use these three examples. Okay, notebook, puzzle book, coloring book. All we have to do is do site amazon.com on Google, and then in title puzzle book. Is puzzle book one word or two word? Looks like it's two words. I'm forgetting English. So we've got 257,000 results, okay, which is really exciting because all of these are puzzle books, okay. Another thing you can do if you want, so let's just have a look at a couple of examples. Let's say you don't want products, okay, so this is a product, but we don't want products. We want, for example, Amazon search result pages like this. In my opinion, and it's always been my opinion, this is much more useful for us. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do in URL, and I'm going to put slash s question mark k, and now we've got 2,000 results, okay? But this should be some interesting results. So if I open this one, for example, I think that's just a misspelling of Sudoku, so that's not very good for us. Sliding puzzle, interesting, 144 results. I guess that's pretty good. Word fill, interesting. Sudoku, no. Puzzle books for kids, no. It's not very useful for us. I'm not a robot, Google, I promise. Fill in puzzle books, no. Another thing we can do is coloring books as well. Kappa Sudoku puzzle, I don't know what that means. Maybe that's a good keyword to make some cheeky Sudoku sales. Penny press fill in puzzle books, don't know what that means. Code word puzzle books, only 900 results. Very interesting. Very, very interesting, guys. Look, this is 2022. This person here is going to be making sales. Clarity Media, 12 sales already. Someone else get in this niche, guys, because it looks like it's making sales for sure. Wooden puzzle box, that would be an interesting one to sell on Etsy if you were making them, or dropshipping, I guess. Okay, I want to try something different. So I'm going to put tools here, and I'm going to put any time, and I'm going to put the past month. Perfect. This is exactly what I wanted. Dog puzzle bowl, no. Puzzle toys for puppies, no. No, none of those are very good. Okay, let's try notebook. Let's try something different. So notebook. Past month still. Spiral notebook, no. Stellagraph notebook, interesting. I think we could make these. Don't know how it works, but yeah, maybe. That's KDP. I don't really know if that's KDP. So another thing we can do if we want to make sure that they are all KDP results is we can... Oh, okay, so most of these are KDP. I was just reading about what KDP was. So yeah, you can make notebooks on KDP. Very, very interesting. Numbered notebook, only 737 results. Very, very interesting, guys. Because if you just take notebook, it's going to have millions of results, okay? But if you, as soon as you add any other keyword to a keyword, except something like funny, it's going to have way less results. Kids wide ruled notebook. Interesting. Very interesting. These are all things that you'd have to discover how to make these, because I have absolutely no idea how to make these. But I'm sure this is something, if you're into KDP, you probably know how to do this. Alphabeticized notebook. Interesting. Password book. Ooh. 1,800 sales. Interesting. I wonder if this is KDP. If this is KDP, this is insane. Basically. Pink hardcover notebook. Really? Only has 900 results. How is that possible? 792 results. That's insane. That's a lot lower than if you just search for notebook. Okay. Okay, so final example is going to be coloring book. So coloring book. As you can see, search operators are perfect for this method because they just allow us to see everything that is ranking on Google, every single Amazon page that is ranking on Google that has coloring book in the title is visible here. That's why I love this so much, this method so much. This is a product though. Oh, because it has S and K in the URL. That's why that's coming up, because I have in URL S and K here. Okay, let's find some decent examples using this, and then we will finish. A lot of these have a lot of results. I think coloring is a really, really, it might be like a, not a dead niche, but Peter Pauper, interesting. What is that? Oh, it's a brand. Okay, so one final thing we can do is we can put in text and then we can put 57 results, maybe. It's probably not going to work. Oh, it does work. Okay, so we can put any number here. Remember this. Okay, you can change this number to any number. 12 results. Let's have a look. Is this a product? No, it's not. What was that keyword? FU coloring books for grown-ups. I swear that's a good keyword. That's interesting. Yeah, so this is how we can find very, very low competition things. I'm not saying, well, I am saying that you probably will make some sales. It's hard to say whether you'll make sales. But in my opinion, it's much better to be able to find low competition. And then you can combine this method with something like Google Trends or you know, something that gives keyword volumes to check whether they're worth making or not. Okay, this is copyright, do not make this. Okay, so I will leave this base search operator in the description. All you have to do is copy and paste it into Google. If you want to find low competition ones, you can use the in-text trick. If you want to find fresh keywords, you can use the when it started ranking here on tools. That could be an interesting one. Shopkins coloring books for girls. What is Shopkins? What is a Shopkin? I guess it's this like animal. So let's use this as an example and let's check the trademark to see if it's trademarked. And then if it is, obviously you wouldn't use it. Shopkins. It's probably going to be trademarked. I would guess it is. It is. Nice. Okay. So we don't make that, obviously. Winter coloring book. Interesting. Oh, 4,000 results. Never mind. Another thing you can do is you can add keywords to, like, if you wanna make something about a coloring book for children, let's say, you can put in text for kids. So basically, we're searching through Amazon. We're making Amazon into a searchable entity using Google, and all of these pages that you can see are indexed on Google. All of these are, yeah, they're index pages, basically. So that's why this is so interesting, because everything we can see is on Google. It's ranking, and Google only ranks things in 2021/2022. Google is only ranking things that it actually thinks are worth ranking, or indexing things that it actually thinks are worth indexing. Okay, that's a really important point about this method, because people always ask me, how do you know if this is going to sell? How do you know if this is going to sell? And the way that we know is because we can make a guess. If it's indexed on Google, Google obviously thinks it's worth indexing it on Google, and therefore we can expect it to get some organic traffic. That's the logic I use personally. I'm going to make another video, another couple of videos on KDP, because I've discovered some very interesting things about Kindle Direct Publishing. So if you're interested, make sure to subscribe so you see those videos, and I'll see you really soon with some more content. Peace out.